everyone. It's Sunday, and you know what that means. It's now time for our bold review dito sa High School Sundays para sa High School on Sex 2 or High School on Sex Season 2. And this episode is entitled Dates, Detentions, and Discoveries. Yeah, we're gonna go with Team 3D over here. At saka ito ay isa sa mga, isa is the fallout nung nangyari last week, which is the mid-season finale. Now we are here at the mid-season premiere, episode 4. So without ano, sana po i-like nyo yung video na to, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon para mapunta tayo sa For You section on YouTube and for more bold review dito sa High School Sundays ng ating channel. I'm yours truly, the God Gamer himself, Harriet Vivamax Velasco. Happy Thanksgiving. Ayun. So, we start this episode up with yung fallout ng pagtatalik nila Aiko Garcia at Angelica Hart with their respective characters, Joanne and Allaine. Ayun. So, Joanne and Allaine gossip in the bathroom while getting themselves dressed after their makeout session sa seat. And from there on, they became friends. And that's fallout number one. Fallout number two is, di ba, na-cliffhanger tayo, sinundan ni Erica itong si Paco papunta sa guidance office. And the prediction of the episode is matutuklasan ni Erica na nagkikipagtalik si Paco. What turns out is that wala pa si Miss Holly, si Mrs. H, sa opisina na yun. So, nauna si Paco, then si Erica, then behind the Erica is Mrs. H. And, ayun, Mrs. H received a text, one from Paco, who is getting ready for a quickie sa guidance counselor's office bago yung parade, kasi di ba last week pickup parade, and then what, or pick and parade, what, pick me up parade, or what, whatever you call it. And it also ended with Brian Ricafort punching Amber, who is known as Albert ata yung tunay niyang pangalan. I don't know. Ganun. Sinuntok si Amber. Ayun. So, the quickie is cancelled at pumunta si Mrs. Holly dun sa pinangyarihan ng insidente ng kanyang anak. Furthermore, she told Erica to attend to Brian at the counselor's office, and then they had their first makeout session sa counselor's office. Kasi natagpuan ni Erica na nag-undress si, ano, si Paco, and that just to make an scapegoat of himself because he's caught red-handed undressing himself at the office of the guidance, eh nakipagtalik siya kay Erica. Of course, ecstatic si Erica dito on the next day kasi nakipagtalik siya sa crush niya eh. Ayun. Third fallout is between Brian and Amber. So, Brian and Amber were sent to detention, and yung detention dito is kakaiba. It's like more of a community service than a detention. Community service siya at nilagay sila sa pangangalaga ng isang manang na isang homophobic na matandang babae. Yun. That's the least, that's the, yeah, yung walang least positive thing I said. We found out na yung parang caretaker na sinend ni Principal Cornelio Gatmaitan kina nung sinend ni Principal Cornelio Gatmaitan si Brian saka si Amber has a husband that cheated on her for yung kumpare niyang bakla. So it's like my father myself type of situation, di ba? Sa my father myself, si Jay Cuenca may affairs kay Alan Paul na tatay ni Shande Guzman doon. As yung si Jay Cuenca, tinira niya yung mag-ama. Tinuhog niya yung mag-ama doon. So, yeah, it's the same situation. Having been depressed dito sa nangyari, namatay yung matanda. Yeah, and this episode It's a shocker. Kala ko aksidente lang, bigla nag-collapse kasi si Manang. Pero ang nangyari, matay pala. Ayun, namatay pala. But this depression deepens the connection between Brian and Amber. By the end of the episode, they held hands and I think they're lovers. Then we get to the revelation. It is MJ Ayabyab's character, Milo, that actually leaked the video of Brian Ricafort. Si Brian Ricafort is a dealer of R-rated 18 videos. For YouTube purposes, I am not going to say the P word, pero alam niyo na yun. And yung exposure was blamed on Amber, but it was Milo. Milo's, in Milo's defense, sabi niya, Brian is so going against the gay agenda. Kasi bakla si Brian, pero parang galit siya sa bakla. It is a matter of struggling to find his own sexuality. And this irates Milo to the point na he made a deal with Brian and this deal parang ginamit niya against Brian, expose him as a dealer of adult videos. Yun na lang, okay? Then we go fast forward, we go back, we take a step back with Winji and Bullet. So after all of these events, hindi pa rin sila tapos makipagtalik sa storage room. To the point na ayaw ni Bullet pero gusto pa rin ni G. It turns out G is the most sexually active among the group and she wants more. And this reflects on her personality. She is now wearing parang ano, yung transformation ni Maui Taylor sa gamitan. Alam mo yun, diba? Nung una nakipagtalik si Maui Taylor kay Wendell Ramos, the next day, iba, nag-makeup na, nag-ayos. She looks more like a, yung mga, ano, SLUT na type na estudyante. So, we find na si Bullet ay nasangkot sa isang sindikato. May utang siyang 20 mil. And G pays it off with her necklace. And they kiss up in the sunset. Ewan ko, that's how I see it. Another plot here is what happened between Aiko Garcia's character and Angelica Hart's character, Joanne and Allaine. So, Joanne is recruiting people for the fellowship. Okay? Kasi may anniversary yung church niya. Remember, Joanne is a church girl and she is actually struggling with her sexuality as well. Kasi parang, ngayon, nagiging type niya mga babae. Imbes na lalaki as revealed in episode 2. However, or furthermore, iniwan ng nanay ni Allaine, si Allaine sa Maynila kasi magsisibo siya, and Allaine has to stay with her grandmother. Joanne took the opportunity to recruit Allaine to her church as parang akay. Ayun, mission. Ito yung pagmimission, puspusang pagpapalaganap. Title of your episode. And from ang nangyari doon, baka matiwalag ako sa title na yun, no? Puspusang pagpapalaganap. Ewan ko. Baka naman hindi. Try natin. Okay, so, naakay naman niya successfully itong si Allaine. At nakita ni Allaine yung character ni Armina Allegri dito na part ng fellowship. It turns out, isa sa mga discovery dito, may relasyon dati, o nakipagtalik dati si Allaine. Remember, Allaine is a gender fluid. Siya yung mix almendras dito sa episode na to. And she has a past experience with Armina Allegri. Upstairs, we find out na attracted itong si Joanne sa anime and monsters. And she made Allaine wear anime skinky anime clothing for the benefit of it, tapos nagtalik sila. And this episode ends with what we presume would happen in episode 1. Paco and Miss H had a quickie. Then, to parang mag-seek ng advice and guidance kasi to fix yung nangyari kay Milo being the leaker of the video. Eh, kakausapin nila si Miss Holly. Hindi ata nila alam na anak ni Miss Holly si Brian. But sure. So, Erica tries to inspect the room again along with Milo. She decides to go in first and discovers na nagtatalik itong si Paco sa kasi Miss Holly, which disappoints Erica. Erica then We see in the final episode Erica crying and yung manyak na professor lumapit sa kanya. And that is the end of episode 4. What do I think? I think solid. Very solid. Lahat ng episode 4 ng Vivamax original series, napakasolido yung dating. Kasi nga fallout ng mid-season ano, finale. We see some plot resolved in the mid-season finale and we get to see new plots open up. And we get to see something to build up to sa finale ng episode na to. Especially yung discovery ni Erica na yung kanyang crush na si Paco ay may gusto kay Miss Holly. Ayun. So yes, that is my review this week on High School Sundays. This Friday, on the birthday special, we are going to review Lechoneras, the Vivamax original movie Lechoneras, starring Yen Durano. This is your boy, the God Gamer Harriet, telling you goodbye and good night!